Welcome to another mythical episode of Feed Dump. I am an onager, a wild ass who can predict the spring equinox. Joining me this week is a manticore.
I have the face of a woman, the body of a lion, the tail of a scorpion, and the liver of a wombat.
And a bonicon.
Hey girl, I'm a goat that can shoot flaming poop up to 2 acres.
Terrific. And we're gonna spray flaming crap all over this place. A 52-year-old Ontario man has been charged with stunt driving after going 143 kilometers per hour. His excuse was that he'd just washed his car and was trying to dry it off.
That will technically dry your car, but also leaving your car still will dry it off. Also, driving the speed limit will dry it off. It sounds like he needs a more effective excuse.
I want to be a little bit better, because your idea is dumb. Super Pokemon!
Super effective. Sorry, officer. My wife is suing me for alimony, and I want to kill myself and others. Super effective.
I'm sorry, officer. I'm trying to defrost this ham, so I strapped it to the engine block, and if I don't drive fast enough, it won't defrost in time, and then the party will be ruined. It's just going to be a mess. Super effective.
I'm sorry, officer. I had to drive that fast because it makes the engine incredibly loud, and I needed to drown out the pounding and screaming of the hooker I have trapped in the trunk. Super effective.
I'm sorry, officer, you may not realize, but 143 kilometers is actually 88.8 miles per hour, and I need to get to that speed so I can go back in time and make sure that my parents kiss at the dance.
That sounds super effective, Marty!
So it's super shitty to live in Venezuela right now, but hopefully not too shitty, because the country has just run out of toilet paper and is planning on importing 50 million rolls.
They seriously don't have any unwanted books or magazines just laying around? Copies of Star? Back issues of Vogue? Dianetics.
Broadleafed ferns.
Seriously, every time I go to the grocery store and it's like Kim Kardashian this and Teen Mom that, and I don't know who these people are and I don't think anybody else cares.
Better than reading them.
Where exactly are they importing all this toilet paper from?
Don't people need those 50 million rolls that they're importing?
The Venezuelan commerce minister said that this is actually an excessive demand that has been drummed up by a media campaign seeking to disrupt the country.
There's no such thing as having a stockpile of too much toilet paper. Like, I only live with one other person, and we have to have at least 12 rolls at a time, and that stuff evaporates very quickly. One chilly weekend, and you are fucked.
Remember that story that we did a couple weeks ago about how Justin Bieber had to surrender his monkey to the German authorities because he didn't have the right papers? That monkey is Germany's now.
Deutschland, Deutschland, land of monkeys opening their doors to tiny things. Monkeys in Germany? Why not? They're not native, but who cares? Justin Bieber, you're a twat.
See, Bieber didn't have, like, the correct quarantine documents or whatever, and so they took it to a shelter, and he didn't pay for the shelter, which he's supposed to do, and didn't submit the documents, and so the shelter's like, well, it belongs to the German government now. Now we have a monkey.
So how much of that monkey is Germany's and how much of it is the EU's?
I don't know, but if Germany thinks the UK is going to pay for any of this monkey's care, they have another thing coming. If it abandoned it in Greece, Germany would still be paying. Political joke.
I bet I know why it's been quarantined. The monkey is a carrier of Bieber fever.
Otherwise known as gonorrhea.
The monkey's doing well, except that it doesn't know correct monkey social behavior because it's only been hanging around Justin Bieber.
So it doesn't know correct human social behavior either.
Aw, Zed Snap, son! He went there.
When Washington State legalized recreational marijuana, they figured everything out. They've got plans for how they're going to sell it, how they're going to monitor it, how they're going to grow it. They got that all worked out. One thing they haven't quite figured out is what they're going to do with the waste, the excess parts of the plant that you don't need to get them dank nugs. Well, one thing they're experimenting with is feeding it to pigs. These pigs get hells of munchies.
So they're way better disposing of the dead prostitutes.
Since the stems aren't even like the active part of the plant, and then it's going through the whole being eaten by a pig process, this would never work. But if there were like pot-infused bacon, there'd be no logical stopping point, because you'd eat some bacon, and you get the munchies, and then be like, oh, I have all this bacon, and you eat some bacon, and then you get the munchies, and you'd be like, oh, I have all this bacon. And then 3 hours later, you're just like, I can see through time.
Coincidentally, The End of Time is just a DVD of The Big Lebowski playing on loop forever. There are worse things. It could be a DVD of Showgirls, or Southland Tales.
Hey, I learned a very important lesson from Southland Tales, and that is that I'm a pimp. And pimps don't commit suicide. So until next time, remember, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat. Nor should they, because they aren't pimps.
a minute, don't capybaras live around there? Like, they look soft and absorbent. Problem solved.